this Nintendo Switch gone bad. The owner said that the console couldn't detect the microSD card when booting into the custom firmware, but it runs fine under stock firmware. So let's inspect the console and hopefully we can fix it. Let's get started. First, let's inspect the console. Insert a microSD card into the console and turn it on. It's stuck at the Nintendo Switch logo. Let's press the power button and try rebooting the console. It took a little longer to boot into the home screen, but at least it worked. Let's open the system settings and see if it detects the microSD card. As you can see, the console detects the microSD card under stock firmware. Logically, the console should detect the same thing under custom firmware. Let's turn off the console. I will put the console into RCM mode and try running Hekate. The loading time is not normal and we don't usually see this kind of notification. It says missing LP0 and missing old Minerva library, etc. You can remove the RCM jig if you want to. And let's try pressing any key to continue. It says failed to init SD card. It means Hekate cannot detect the inserted microSD card. Let's continue. Select console info. Then choose print SD card info. Again, it says the same thing. Fail to init SD card. I'm very sure that there is something wrong with the SD card reader or the connector. Now go back and turn off the console. Remove the microSD card from the console. We are going to disassemble this faulty tablet. You need a Tri-Ring 00 and Philips 00 screwdriver, a tweezer, a 30 gauge Kiner wire, a soldering iron, and its lid. Remove these 4 screws with the Tri-Ring screwdriver. Then remove the rest with the Phillips screwdriver. Let's remove the microSD card reader from the console. Remove the sponge. Be very careful because you don't want to break the connector below it. Then remove the screw. And you can remove the SD card reader completely. Next, we need to check the SD card reader connector. It seems there is a missing pin down there. To get a better view, it is better to remove the metal case. Let's re-inspect the SD card reader connector. Indeed, there is a missing pin on the connector. I tried to take a clearer picture, and there we go. The missing pin should cause the SD init failed problem. Since this part is tiny, I think it is too risky to replace the whole connector. So I think the best option is to solder a wire to this pad and connect it to the SD card reader pin. So it should look like this one. Remember to use a 30 gauge Kainer wire. You don't need to use a long Kainer wire. 5 cm is good to go. Next is to determine the solder point on the SD card reader. For my case, I need to jump a wire to this pin. But since the connector is too small, then we need to use a multimeter to find out the corresponding solder point at the top of the SD card reader. And thankfully, I have found the solder point. Since we have removed the metal plate, then it is mandatory to reapply a new thermal paste at the top of the heatsink. Reinstall the metal plate. Keep an eye on the jumper wire and make sure you didn't put the whole wire under the metal plate. So this is how I soldered the jumper wire to the SD card reader. It is tricky to do it, but the point is it is less risky than replacing the whole connector. Let's screw the card reader down. Insert the micro SD card into the console. Then turn it on. There is no freezing, and the loading time is back to normal. And the SD card is detected by the console. Now turn off the console and get into the RCM mode. And inject the Hekate payload. It is now booting into the Hekate menu. It means that the repair process has been successful. Let's launch the custom firmware to test it further. Okay, it seems very normal. Let's remove the dongle and the RCM jig and begin reinstalling the back cover. Don't forget to remove the micro SD card before placing the back cover. Now let's do the final check. Reinsert the micro SD card into the console, then boot Hekate. the console is now back to normal. Please note that this solution might not work on your console since there are a lot of causes and possibilities of a not working console. But I'm glad I have fixed this console and hope this guide can enlighten you to repair your broken Nintendo Switch. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.